Lauren asks, what are some of your favorite Metal Jesus Rocks episodes? So Lauren, I'm really glad you asked this question because I also want to throw it out to you guys. I'm really curious to know, of the 365 videos I've created so far, like what are some of your favorites? I'm going to tell you some of mine here in a second, but yeah, I'm really kind of curious to know because, you know, some are liked more than others and some of them are a little bit more adventurous than others. And so I'd love to know what you guys think. Also too, I'm at a point where, you know, I'm almost at 250,000 subscribers. It's pretty crazy. So yeah, at the making of this video, I'm very close to that. And I, you know, a little background for you guys. While that's a lot of subscribers, and I've been very fortunate, very blessed to also get a lot of views, and a lot of people who kind of watch my videos, but at the end of the day, I still feel like I'm right around that 10,000 level, you know? And the reason for that is, quite frankly, is because, you know, every video I make, I never know if it's gonna be like a video that a lot of people connect with, and I still get nervous right before every video goes out because I put so much work into it and I want to do a good job. You know, I don't want to screw up some little detail. It's so easy to do because we don't script any of this stuff. And also too, you know, I have so many special guests on my channel that I want to do a good job for them. I want them to be proud to be on my channel. And so, you know, every Tuesday and Friday, right before a video comes out, I do get nervous and I watch the comments closely to see if there's some major screw up or, you know, I watch it throughout the week to make sure that the people are still liking it and all that sort of stuff. So I don't know if that's silly or not, but you know, it's just that a part of me that wants to always do better. So with that, what are some of my favorite episodes? I do get this question from people because I do cover a wide variety of stuff, as you guys know. I mean, yes, I do have hidden gems videos, and yeah, I've got some top 10 videos and some of the typical things that a lot of people do, pickups videos, things like that, where a lot of other channels do them. But I very specifically also try to do things that are a little bit outside of my comfort zone. And, you know, those would be like the Gamer Eats and the I Hate You episodes. And so some of my favorite episodes. Okay. Well, I mentioned the Gamer Eats and the I Hate You episodes. Those are some of the most fun videos to shoot and make. And it should be pretty obvious because it looks like we're having a great time. More specifically, from a content creation standpoint, though, they are really crazy to create because essentially we don't script anything. So I basically create an environment where I hope something interesting will happen and we'll capture that on camera. And you know, like for instance, in the I Hate You episodes, typically those are about an hour of footage. So we play those games and it's about an hour or so. And then we have green screen that we shoot over there. And so when I sit down to edit those videos, I don't know how it's gonna turn out. I basically have to take that full hour of footage and whittle it down to something that people actually watch. And that's a very challenging thing to do, to ride that line between something that's too long and kind of come on, get to the point, to you know, something that maybe is too short that doesn't make any sense. Plus mixing in all the green screen interview stuff. But they're a ton of fun to make. I love doing that. It's a huge challenge. To give you an idea, those videos usually take anywhere from 20 to 40 hours just to edit. There's so much work involved, but I love doing it. So those are really fun. Also the Gamer Eats, you know, when it comes to Drunken Master Paul, all I have to do is turn on the camera and he gives me something. He basically, you know, the silly monkey in him will just do something and I know it's going to be great. And plus we have such a long friendship that we really know each other's strengths and weaknesses, and so we play off each other very well. So I really look forward to the Gamer Eats episodes. Looking back through my catalog, one video really stands out, and that is a pickups video I did. I don't remember, it's gotta be 3 or 4 years ago. Basically, it was right after PAX, and during that weekend, I got to meet a bunch of people like the Game Chasers, Pete Doerr, and things like that. But this pickups video, I wanted to be something kind of different. It was during the summer here in Seattle, and I was like, you know what? I'm gonna take all of the games that I found, I'm gonna go to a park, and I'm gonna shoot a pickups video in the park for no other reason other than just to get out of the game room and kind of challenge myself to see if I could do that. Also, for that video, for the first time, I used a lapel mic. It's a little mic that sits right here, and it's strung all the way across over to the camera because I knew there'd be a lot of ambient sounds and things like that. And so if you remember that video, one of the interesting things I did not expect was that off to the side, this is a very dense park, and off to the side there was this guy who was kind of hiding in the bushes, and he looked sketchy as hell. And he just kind of watched me. I mean, you know, looking back, I'm like, yeah, he's probably wondering what this guy is doing with all these games on this park bench. But I was getting pissed. I was like, you know, and I actually left in some of that B-roll. And you should go back and watch it if you're curious, because I was getting pretty pissed. I was like, you know, what the hell is this guy doing? Like, is he gonna try to steal my games? You know, I became like a mother hen, like, you know, protecting her chicks. I was just like, come on, man, bring it on, you know, I'll take you down. But that was pretty funny to do. And also leaving in that B-roll, I at the time I was like, oh man, I don't know if people are gonna wanna see this really weird scenario going on with this creeper who's hanging out in the bushes. But it turns out that most of you guys who watched that video loved it. So that was a lot of fun. Also, I would say over the years, I very quickly realized that while I know big box PC games and Sierra games and some of, you know, maybe Xbox and things like that, but I wanted to broaden my channel and the content, and I knew that I was not going to know everything about the 40 plus years of video games. And so I was like, huh, well then I will start bringing on some local collectors, or I'll go down to a collector's game room. Now, one of the first times I ever did that was I hopped in a car with Drunken Master Paul, and we headed down to John Hancock's Room of Doom. And that video, I think, is one of the funniest videos on my channel, because if you want to know something about me, is that while I'm a great planner when it comes to maybe this sort of stuff, but in life, I just wing it a lot of times. And that was one of the times where literally we got in the car, started driving the 2 hours to Longview, Washington, and I didn't have John's phone number. I didn't have his address. And we didn't even really talk about it except for about halfway down. And you see it in the video where Paul asked me, he's like, do you know where this guy lives? And it was real. Like the reaction on that video is real. He was like, are you kidding me? We're going to a town we don't know to find a guy we barely know. It was pretty funny.
Do you have any clue where we're going?
No, I have no idea. He gave me an address that's sitting at home on the counter. Seriously.
I hate you so much.
It's true, I know.
So, what's your plan there, Metal Jesus?
Lost. We're lost.
We're dead.
Yeah. This could be Mexico, for all I know. I have no idea how
Let's just say it is. We've driven to Mexico.
Yeah. Hola! ¿Cómo está? And also, too, that video turned into like a three-parter. The first part of that is driving down to Longview and kind of the shenanigans that happen in the car. The second half is in his Room of Doom, and then we wrapped it up on the third video, plus outtakes and stuff like that. And that is a classic video. I just love that so much. And so if you haven't seen these videos, I will definitely put a link down in the description below, because I think they're really fun. And then finally, pretty much any sort of hidden gems video where somebody comes on my channel and we just kind of connect in a really funny and weird way. Like, and examples are, I mean, not necessarily weird ways, but like just connecting with Reggie and Kinsey and Kelsey and John Riggs and all these people, Anna, who have come on here. And yes, we're talking about games. Yes, we're you know, kind of being a little bit more descriptive, or you know, trying to give you good information, but we'll have moments where we're teasing each other, or maybe they're picking on me, or we're just, it's just real, you know. And that's what I love about my channel and my videos, is that video games are fun, and that's kind of the vibe I've always wanted to have on my channel. And bringing these collectors on, and these people in the community, is that games are fun. And I love those moments where we just kind of go a little bit off the rails and We're a little bit silly. You get to see a bit of our personalities, and that's gold to me. And even if we screw up, but we're having a good time, that's what I really like. I think it's really fun, really important, and I think you guys have enjoyed that as well. So a little bit of a retrospective, a little bit of, I don't know, just sort of like a video where I'm looking back at the 365 videos I've done so far. Again, I'd love to know what you guys think about the videos I've created, some of your favorites. Please post a comment below. I'm gonna read all of them and probably comment on a bunch of them too. So, all right guys, well, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and take care.